Greetings. I asked a friend recently, "Do you think we are in the last days?" They answered with the following verse. Matthew 24:36. "But of that day and hour knows no man, no, not the angels in heaven, but my Father only." And I had a response, but I held my tongue. And tonight I was going to make a long video about Matthew 24. I was going to read Matthew 24, verse 1 and 2, and then he goes out privately and sits on the Mount of Olives, and his disciples come to him. They ask Jesus, "When shall these things be, and what shall be the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world?" And Jesus answers in Matthew 24:4, and says to them, "Take heed that no man deceive you." I was making a video about Matthew 24 until I got to the following verse. "For many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many." For many years I read this verse the following way. "For many shall come in my name, saying, quote, I am Christ, unquote, and shall deceive many." I've read this hundreds of times in my life, and just this moment, I believe it became clear. Okay, show of hands, please. Did you read this to mean there will be lots of people running around, all of them saying of themselves, "I am Christ. I am Christ. No, me too. No, I am Christ. No, you're not Christ. I am Christ." That there will literally be many running around all saying that they are the Christ. What if that is not a quote as in the way we've been taught to read it? Remember, there is no punctuation in the Greek. Try reading it this way and see what I mean. "For many shall come in my name," meaning they are claiming to speak for me, "saying I, Jesus, am the Christ, and shall deceive many." Or, paraphrased a little clearer, "For many shall come, saying, Jesus is the Christ, and shall deceive many."
On the authority of this holy book, the Quran, that Jesus Christ was one of the mightiest messengers of God. We are made to believe that he was born miraculously. We are made to believe that he was the Christ, the Messiah, the Messiah. That Islam is the only non-Christian faith which makes it an article of faith to believe in Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. No Muslim is a Muslim if he does not believe in Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. We believe that he was one of the mightiest messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We believe that he was the Messiah, translated Christ. We are made to believe that he was the Christ, the Messiah, the Messiah. We believe that he was the Messiah, translated Christ. That he was the Christ, the Messiah, the Messiah. He was the Messiah, translated Christ. That he was the Christ.
Saying, Jesus is the Christ and shall deceive many. Kinda sheds a whole new light on this verse, doesn't it, my friend? For many shall come in my name, saying, I, Jesus, am the Christ, and shall deceive many. Pay close attention to this quote by Zakir Naik.
That Islam is the only non-Christian faith which makes it an article of faith to believe in Jesus Christ, peace be upon him.
Islam is a whole new religion created to allow you to believe. A false description of Jesus. Many shall come in my name, for many shall come saying, I am the Christ. It has never really made any sense to me before that the earth would be filled with people all claiming they were the Christ. If the other interpretation never quite satisfied you either, perhaps you now know why. Thank you, Holy Spirit. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.